welcome to the Tiny House Ideas podcast. And with the sort of the traveling that you've done as well around Asia, around the world, has sort of that, because I can imagine you've sort of been away for quite a period of time and had sort of everything maybe on your back or in a few bags. Has that sort of, did that sort of open your eyes to living with less, to minimalism, to tiny living, or did that have an impact?
Definitely. I think for me, it started definitely, you know, I always had like a home base somewhere.
So yeah. Okay. Parents, so stuff you know, can sort of leave.
Right. I keep my stuff at my parents or whatever. And when they ended up moving, when I was like, oh, I guess this was only like 3 or 4 years ago, but having to get rid of a bunch of stuff and stuff just not meaning as much. But I think that that started probably, you know, being in Africa and just living with less. And I came back to the United States and I had a really hard time, almost this reverse culture shock of, you know, I remember walking into a Walmart and just walking right out. Like I was just so overwhelmed.
Exactly. Yeah.
And I just, all this stuff. And you know, that was, I was 20, 21. And so I was young. And then, you know, all of these things are happening, graduating college, getting a job, you know, being in a relationship. And again, thinking, well, I got to have the house. I have to have the stuff. I have to have all of these things. And so, you know, over time, it took me, you know, it took me a few years to realize that stuff was just giving me anxiety and it didn't serve a purpose, or it didn't, you know, you just didn't need it. And so I really kind of got back to, yeah, I want to pick up and move. And because I moved so much, I didn't have a lot to begin with, you know, it wasn't like, you know, we would easily pack up like a small U-Haul and just, that was fine. And we would get rid of things during moves. And so obviously you kind of drop things off, but, yeah, I was in a position where we bought the house and we were buying the things and doing what we were supposed to do. And I just panicked. And I think that living out of a suitcase, I'm totally fine with that. That doesn't bother me, but I know that's not for everyone. But getting rid of stuff is definitely a freeing process.
Yeah, definitely. I was going to say very freeing.
Yeah. And you just, it's not necessarily that I'd want to be able to, you know, fit everything into one suitcase and go at any given time. I'm okay with having things. I wouldn't even necessarily consider myself a minimalist fully. But I'm happiest with fewer things. I'm happiest, you know, when I'm in the field doing research and I've got, you know, I've got one backpack and that we're here for 3 weeks and this is, you know, this is what we're going to do. There's some simplicity in that, and decisions are made for you because you don't have a choice. You don't have all of these things.
Yes. Yeah.
And that's really nice. I think that for me is calming in a way.
Yeah, no, me too. I mean, I think it's a sort of, like you said, if you've got so many things, then there is a sort of a choice that has to be made. It's like a decision fatigue, really, isn't it? If you've got sort of 10 options to choose from, then you're going to use all of that mental energy and you're going to sort of, it's an extra stress. It's another worry. Whereas if you just have one, then by the time you've even thought about what you'd do with the 10, you've already done the job you needed to do.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And that's the thing, I guess, very, very liberating, very freeing. And it's similar to me as well in sort of in terms of the physical space having an impact on the mental space, I guess, because I mean, it all goes back, I guess, to the sort of old quote of a tidy desk means a tidy mind kind of situation. But, I mean, it translates to everything for me, because I think the less sort of superfluous extra stuff that I don't need that doesn't add value, I guess, is just sort of for me taking away from something else I could be doing, or sort of limiting me from doing what I want to do.
Yeah. Well, and I really like that idea. You know, you mentioned kind of mental clarity, and I do think there's, your emotional currency is so valuable. You know, it's not like you have this infinite amount, you know, you really have to safeguard it. And if you're getting frustrated over, you know, picking out an outfit or something, I really think that in the long run, you know, you feel that weighs on you. It's a burden. And so
exactly, all adds up.
Being able to put that elsewhere and towards something that's more fulfilling to you makes a huge difference in the long run.
Thanks for watching this little teaser for the Tiny House Ideas podcast. If you'd like to listen to the full episode, it's available on all major streaming platforms. So that's Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and all of the others. Alternatively, if you'd rather watch it sort of in a video format like this video has been, then that's available on Patreon. Just search for Tiny House Ideas. So thanks again for watching. Please do check out the full episode. And thanks again.